بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Of what we were reading last time from the Majalis al-Shahr al-Ramadan by Sheikh Saleh al-Fawzan Hafidhahullah, which was pertaining to their etiquettes in regard to reading the Quran. What are the etiquettes of reading the Quran? And in it, the Shaykh Hafidhahullah Wara'a, he talked about that one, number one is, anybody remember from the etiquettes of reading the Book of Allah? Yes. Huh? Ahsanta, number one, barakallahu feekum, is that the person must be having wudu. Number one is the person must be, alhamdulillah, in a state of wudu. And he quoted the hadith of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he mentioned that one that does not have wudu does not touch the Quran. And after that, barakallahu feekum, the Shaykh rahimahullah, he mentioned the second one, which was, who remember the second one? The second one was, barakallahu feekum, in regard to saying the isti'adha. Meaning to say, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. To say that which is the isti'adha. And that isti'adha, barakallahu feekum, it is the person he seek protection in Allahu tabaraka wa ta'ala from the accursed shaytan. From the accursed shaitan. And then after that? After the isti'adha? Huh? Naam, after that, the person that is reciting the Quran, he will say the basmala. He will say the basmala, which is to say, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And he say it is the person to be saying the basmala, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, upon the beginning of every surah except Surah Tawbah, because Surah Tawbah, barakallahu feekum, doesn't start with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The second one, barakallahu feekum, was what? After that, he talks about one to be, barakallahu feekum, beautifying his voice in reciting the Quran. Beautifying one's voice in reciting the Book of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And then one after that, alhamdulillah, we had covered, is that one is to be cautious about those who are in his environment. He has to be cautious in those who are in his environment. He say, kawnuhu yura'i man hawlahu. Being in the situation whereas the person got to be very cautious about those who are yani in his surrounding. He say, فَإِنْ كَانَ حَوْلُهُ نَائِمٌ, if he has around him somebody that is sleeping, أو قارئٌ آخر, or another person that is reciting the Quran, أو يصلي, or someone else that is praying, فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَجْهَرُ جَهْرًا. He say he will not be yani reading it in a very audible voice, طيب, in a very audible voice, to the point that you shall wish ala man hawlahu, to the point that he will bring some tashwish, he will bring some confusion to those who are around him, whether they are praying or whether they are reading the Quran like them, or he will not be a disturbance to those who are barakallahu fikum taking the rest or sleeping. So, but he will read, he will read it with while saying it loud enough, bihasbi ma yasma'u nafsahu. He will say it loud enough to hear himself. Not barakallahu fikum too loud to the point that he will disturb others, but he will say loud enough to the point that he will hear himself. He say, وَلَا يُشَوِّشُ عَلَى الْآخَرِينَ, and he will not be a disturbance upon others. So here is, alhamdulillah, reading the book of Allah. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ and who is a better? وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حَدِيثًا وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ قِيلًا, and who is better in speech than Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So even one reciting the book of Allah, he is not to be barakallahu fikum disturbing others. And the Shaykh hafidhahullah, from that he mentioned, وَمِنْ هَذَا نَعْرِفْ, and from that we understand and we know, أن هؤلاء الذين يطلقون أصوات المكابر الصوت. He said those who they put their voice out with the speaker system, and whereas they will have the speakers outside, طيب, to the outside of the masjid, to the point that يوشوشون على الناس, it will create a situation of a confusion, or it will disturb the people that are in their own homes. So if it is being recited in the masjid, it is to be stay at the masjid. It has to stay in the masjid. Likewise, that come to say about, you find in some of the areas, they will have the makabir as-sawt, meaning those microphones or the speakerphones that they will have outside, that you find five masajid, they all be in the same area, and everybody calling the adhan on the microphone. Everybody calling the adhan to the point that if one is calling, the other one is disturbing him. If one is calling, the other one calling is also disturbing him. Or they gotta wait till this masjid call the adhan so we can call the adhan. What is the point? If that masjid call the adhan, you can hear him in the masjid. What is the point of using a microphone? What is the point of using a speaker for speakers and the likes of this? So it is almost like people are competing about who has the biggest amp. That's where the competition is. Not about who followed the sunnah, but who has the biggest audio system, the sound system, who has it to the point that, wal-iyadhu billah, one is to be harming others, wal-iyadhu billah. The Shaykh hafidhahullah, he say, from the etiquettes, from the characteristics of the one that is reciting the Quran, or from the good mannerism in regard to reading the book of Allah, he say, بَلْ مِنَ الْوَاجِبِ فِيهَا, but in regard to that which is from the obligations of those mannerism in reading the Quran, he say, أَنْ يَتَجَنَّبَ اللَّحْنَ الَّذِي يَخْلَأَ بِالْقُرْآنِ, is one that to free himself and remove himself from making these drastic mistakes in reciting the Quran. Whereas he will place a fatha where it is a dhamma, or he will place a dhamma where it is a fatha, or he will place barakallahu fikum a tanween where it is not a tanween, he will place a alif al-lam where it is not a alif al-lam. This barakallahu fikum is what is called a lahn, and this is to be a person reciting the Quran has to be very cautious because of those vowel mark, interchanging them barakallahu fikum can change a whole sentence. It can change a whole sentence. Mathalan, if a person recite وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهَ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا, شوف, when a person say وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهَ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا, he has changed not only the verses, but he has changed the aqidah to salaf, right? Because he is saying that Musa spoke with Allah instead of وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ الْفَاعِلُ هُوَ اللَّهُ وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا, that Allah indeed spoke with Musa, with speech, meaning with that which is in speech. Allah spoke with Musa alayhi salatu wasalam with true speech. So if one say وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهَ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا, that now you are changing who is speaking And you are also changing the what? The aqidah of the Muslims. Because Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He is the one that spoke to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. And Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they affirm by it that indeed Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He speaks. That indeed Allah speaks. Yes, Allah speaks, but we cannot say that Allah is a speaker. Yes, Allah speaks, but we cannot say that Allah is the speaker. Limadha? Well, if I say Allah is Al-Alim, right? Can I say you are a knowledgeable person? Can I say you're a knowledgeable one? I can't say that. Yeah, if you know something, I can say he's knowledgeable about this. Tayyib, I can say Allah is also what? Knowledgeable, right? So why can't we say that Allah is the speaker? Limadha? We have dealt with this. That's the only reason why I ask. Necessarily, I can be speaking on my behalf and be my own speaker. Anyone else? Abdurrahman. Huh? No, Allah ascribed that He speaks, yeah. Abu Bakr. Huh? Not necessarily. Speaking doesn't necessarily mean a person has a throat or doesn't have a throat. Right? On this side. Ismail? Which one? Which is the other one? Right? No. Al-Kalam, Dhati wa Fi'ali. Al-Ilm. Al-ilm, meaning al-kalam, is both. It is dhati and it is fi'li. Why dhati? Because Allah will never cease to speak. Fi'li, because He speaks whenever He wants to. Unto whomever He wants to. طبعاً ليس كمثله شيء, that Allah is not like anyone, but He speaks. Right? No, we're talking about the fact that Allah Ta'ala cannot be said that He is a speaker. But He speaks. No, Allah will never cease to speak. Right? Ala lahul khalqu wal amr. Al khalq is the creation, wal amr is the speech, the command. Because for indeed a command to take place, it must say what? It must say three things. It necessitated as-sawt, what else? Al-huruf and al-ma'ani, the meaning of it. Hayak Allah. Huh? Right. But more so. Tayyib, that also this in line in what he say, but why the text cannot in the text you cannot find a name limada? No, because we, as they say, we affirm for Allah what He affirmed for Himself in a way that is befitting for His might and majesty. But the answer is this: Barakallahu fiikum. The kalam yanqasim ila thalathati aqsam. Speech is divided into three categories. Speech is divided into three categories, meaning there is three types of speech. Help me out now to break down the three types of speech.